Nine is predicting a Labor victory in the Australian federal election 2022. We've had the bish boot, we've had the shredder, we've had the cruncher, we've had everything, the shark pull, you name it. But we've got the ukulele. Thank you to the, I suppose, former Prime Minister now, Scott Morrison, and his appearance on 60 Minutes. So it is time to crank up the robot, crank up the baggage conveyor belt, go to Cuba and start sending them on their way.
And who is first? It is the ALP's member for Griffith. Susan. Goodbye, Terry Butler.
Big call. You might regret that one.
OK, all right. We might live to regret it, but for now, Terry, it's off to Cuba. All right. Have fun there. Thank you, Terry. All right, we are going to do Wentworth. Would someone like to do the honours with
I can't.
Dave Sharma?
No.
Julie Bishop?
No, yeah, no, disappointing. Just like Dave Sharma was a future leader of the Liberal Party. So, yes, the fact that he would be packing his bags and leaving politics at the moment, I think, is a big loss to the Liberal Party. And the story of the night, in fact, is a bloodbath for the Liberals. The National Party we'll speak about in a minute. Well, he's done quite well, but the Liberal Party has bled all over the map. So it will be farewell to Dave Sharma.
And I bring in Kate Ellis again from earlier in the night, where these people are losing their jobs, they are losing their careers, and they go to the supermarket, they go to the local schools, and families see them, and you feel it. So,
yep. And it's also their staff, the people who have dedicated their lives, in some instances, to working with these members. They believe in the cause, and they lose their jobs as well.
And Jason Falinski was certainly not expecting to lose his job tonight, but that certainly looks like he's gone the way of the others with a Teal Independent. So he's gone as well.
But they do say there's nothing as an ex-MP, and I think that's true. The phone stops ringing, era has been pretty quickly.
Lou is now also an ex-MP in the seat of Chisholm, one Labor was predicting to pick up, and certainly Gladys Lou gone.
Okay.
This tells a very long story about the Liberals, though. It is almost all Liberal seats. So Fiona Martin, Liberal seat of Reid, held on a narrow margin, expected to go, and also now packing her bags.
And that was always one that Labor was confident about, wasn't it, Chris?
Yeah. OK, here we go. The seat of Higgins, Katie Allen.
Again, look, a great member, Katie
very
Allen.
Talented,
a doctor,
very
extremely talented.
Very
another moderate Liberal bites the dust. And so we farewell Katie Allen.
A lot of moderate Liberals, won't there be, discussing what's happened, really, won't there be?
Yep.
Well,
Tim Wilson got
the for the Liberal Party to be competitive, it must be the broad church, and it would be foolish for the party not to move back to the centre to have any hope of regaining these
seats. Get this one done. Tim Wilson, Goldstein, another one.
Sorry about this, Jane.
These are all my friends. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is really sad.
Really
these
sad.
Are all my friends.
I understand.
Trent Zimmerman in North Sydney, and certainly he'd been a very nervous man for a very long time. He had good reason to be, and tonight Trent Zimmerman also is leaving federal parliament.
So long, Trent Zimmerman. And who have we got next? Boothby, the dream, Kate Ellis. This was always the daring
the
to dream seat, and it has
finally
happened.
Been discovered. I don't want to talk about it for too long because it means our. Everybody has to keep listening to this song, but this is a very, very big result in terms of South Australia.
And again...
Ken Wyatt.
Oh, wow.
Ken Wyatt.
Yeah.
No, again...
I'm not calling that one.
No, I can't do that. Ken was the first Indigenous member of the House of Representatives, the first Indigenous cabinet minister. He was a great local member. This is heartbreaking.
Yeah, it is. Ken Wyatt, also a great guy, but it would appear that his political career is over, but I'm sure Ken will do other great things. This one I think is hard for anything. I remember I asked Bill Shorten once, Bill, is there anyone from the Liberal side of politics that you'd have in your cabinet? And he said, Josh Frydenberg. Yeah. Josh Frydenberg also
had I already left
very
Bill.
Hard looking.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I think...
Good answer.
No,
correct answer.
Tell you what, I would have sent you to the Solomon Islands. You wouldn't have let it happen.
You wouldn't have needed to. I would have been on the next plane.
But look, we bid farewell to Josh Frydenberg.
Yeah,
Josh
that's a big one, isn't it?
Yeah, sorry, Josh.
He's a loss to the nation.
Mm. Oh, well, but Monique Ryan will do okay.
Oh, look, this had to have at least one bright
this
moment.
One's just
and here it comes again. And we've already done this evening, but there's got to be a reason for this stupid machine, and this is it.
Now, you've always got to feel sorry for the leaders of political parties when they don't win. You know?
Oh, so, we bid a fond farewell to the next Prime Minister of Australia, Craig Kelly, and take your advertising with you, please. Goodbye.
There we go.
But, Kate, what does someone like Josh Frydenberg do now? A corporate job? Will there be offers on the table? What's it like when you lose your job and you then think, well, I know you get a pension or whatever, but You've got to get
well,
a
no, you don't. Josh actually won't.
Yes, exactly. We have to clear this up, by the
everybody
way.
Everybody thinks we do.
Yeah, everybody thinks that every MP gets a pension. But, of course, anyone elected 2004 or onwards won't.
That's super.
So Josh will have lots of offers.
Yeah.
And I imagine he'll have some time out, spend some time with his family and weigh up those options. I imagine there'll be lots of media speculation about state parliament. Or
maybe Labor will offer him an overseas posting. He was an advisor to both Prime Minister Howard and Alexander, just saying, and Alexander Downer and John Howard on foreign affairs. Of course, he'll have offers from corporate Australia, but he is the sort of person who would want to continue to serve the nation.
Okay.